Myself Sri D.K. Kamlakar, Assistant Professor in Center for Distance Education, Shivaji University, Kolhapur. Today, we are going to learn MCOM Part 2, Semester 4, topic name Management Control System. Under this, we have in the syllabus Reporting to Management. So let's understand the reporting to the management means what. At every moment, management want to take decision for operating business. Unless and until the information is available about the phenomena, nobody can take the decision. By taking proper and timely decision, management can sustain business and grow it as per the organizational goal. Hence, proper reporting plays an important role in management accounting process. Management reporting is nothing but transferring information to management. It is a process of providing information to management. Reports are sent regularly to various levels of management. It is useful to them to judge the effectiveness of respective responsibility centers. Meaning of reporting. Report is a tool of conveying the information to higher authorities for proper decision making and consequently favorable effect. Report helps management to frame out different policies. With the help of report, management can evaluate the performance of various divisions and sections within the organization and people working therein. Reports are useful to assessing the policy implementation. They also assist management to take corrective actions if an unfavorable situation occurs. It also helps to control the situation and affairs of the business. Reporting system is the formal system which continuously fed the information to management to assist decision making. According to the Anthony and Reis, reports on what has happened in the business are used for two general purposes which may be called information and control respectively. Now we can learn the methods of reporting. Reporting may be made by written reporting, graphical reporting or oral reporting. The method of reporting depends upon nature of information required, the volume of data and the media available for communications. Written reporting. Different written reports include formal financial statements, tabulated information and accounting ratios. Graphical reporting. Some reports are presented in the form of charts, diagrams and pictures. Due to such reports, the trends of information are grasped quickly. Oral reporting can be done in the form of group meeting and conversation with individuals. It is helpful for limited extent. In actual practice, a single method is not sufficient. A combination of written, graphical and oral reporting may be useful for the organization. Now we can learn the types of reports. The reports are classified on the basis of different factors, which are follows. Classification of reports on the basis of period. One, routine report, that is daily report, and special reports. Classification of reports on the basis of functions. One, operating reports and financial reports. Classification of reports on the basis of nature, enterprise report, control reports, and investigative reports. Classification of reports on the basis of purpose, external reports, and internal reports. Let's understand each report in a deep way. Routine reports. These reports are prepared and submitted as a regular activity. They are about day-to-day working of organization. They are periodically sent to the various levels of management according to nature of information and detail to be reported. These reports are different. Important information should be highlighted as in this report. Maybe these reports sent daily, weekly, monthly, and quarterly. Routine reports may be related to sales, production, capital expenditure, purchase, market trends, and labor situation, etc. Now, special reports. The special reports are required in a special situation or for special purpose. Available data may not be sufficient, so additional data may be collected specially. According to the J. Batty, special reports should be divided into sections, each covering the following main purpose: reason for the report, investigation made, and findings, conclusions, and recommendations. Next, operating report. Operating reports are divided into two: information reports and control reports. Information reports facilitate information useful for policy prescriptions. Trend reports provide information in comparative form over a period of time. Control reports are used for managerial purpose or managerial control. They are useful for immediate corrective actions to be taken. They may be used to assess the performance of an individual. Control reports are for measuring and comparing performance or evaluation of performance. Then financial reports. Financial reports facilitate the information related to financial performance. The income statement provides outlook of financial result, and the balance sheet put the fourth financial position. Fund flow statement reflects source of funds and application of funds for the business, which indicates the funds management. Cash flow statement shows inflow of cash and outflow of cash, which reveals cash management. Next, enterprise report. Enterprise reports are prepared for the organization as a whole. They may concern all activities of the enterprise or may be related to different activities. These reports are useful to outsiders. Enterprise reports include balance sheet, income statement, income tax return, employment report, chairman's report, and director's report, etc. Next, control report. Control reports are related to personal performance and the economic performance. The performance of a manager and head of responsibility center is evaluated. The efficiency of responsibility center is tested as an economic entity. The reason for deviation in performance are also identified. Next, investigative reports. If any serious issue arises, the causes of the situation studied and analyzed. These studies are used to prepare investigative reports. The investigative reports are prepared according to the nature of every situation, and they are useful to management to analyze the causes of the problem. External reports. Many parties are interested to know about the organization. These outsiders who are interested in company's report may be shareholders, suppliers, bankers, creditors, potential investors, regulatory bodies, etc. Hence, it has to prepare reports meant for external users, which are called external reports. Main example of external reports is financial statements. Internal reports, the reports which are prepared for the purpose of internal use of the organization are called internal reports. They are not available for external users. These reports mainly used for decision making by management. They are meant for top level, middle level and lower level management. Students, today we learn the reporting to management means what, and finally we seen the various types of reports. If you have any queries related to this topic, please contact me on my mobile number 973-000-5683. See you very soon in next video. Still time. Thank you very much.